What I love about them is the fact that it allows a cinema audience to go inside an event that they have no comprehension of, really, other than a few paragraphs in a history book or on a newspaper or so forth. And so for a filmmaker, it's the opportunity through the characters that you create to take an audience inside those catastrophic or enormous events and let them see it from the inside. It's sort of, it's our pre-visual reality. The characters become our, those glasses that Sony put out now, and allow them to experience those events through ordinary characters, particularly characters who find their humanity and their strength in dealing with those events. So I think it's produced the greatest films in cinema history: Schindler's List, Missing, Reds, The Killing Fields, Apocalypse Now, Deer Hunter, all of those great films. And the catastrophe of cinema at the moment is it's being neglected in favor of higher grosses at the box office, and I think that would be a real tragedy if this genre died out. There's two sides to this. There's the political influence of the Turkish government, which has, over the course of a century, managed to stifle and repress and deny this event. And today, their strategic importance is greater than ever. And this is a touchstone for them. Any time that the Armenian genocide is mentioned, whether it be the centenary or a film like this, there's immediately a barrage of denial. And the thing is, it's for me and for the world to face this, this is not a question of did it happen or if it happened. The vast majority of historical study in this has firmly established that this was a planned attempt to wipe out the Armenian nation. And we need to get beyond that diversionary discussion to why. Why did it happen, and how do we move on from that, and how do you reconcile these two nations again? And for me making this, I think one of the most important things, and this has also been denied, but a British barrister, Geoffrey Robinson, very distinguished, has firmly established this. Adolf Hitler in 1939 held a meeting of his generals in one of his villas before they invaded Poland, and he was talking about creating breathing, living space for the German people. And he instructed those generals that they had to be completely brutal and wipe out populations and villages and so forth. And he had an argument, particularly with one Admiral Canaris, who went on to be one of the attempted assassins of him. And Canaris wrote in his diary afterwards, "Hitler turned around and said, 'Who now speaks of the Armenians?'" So the very suppression of that event and the fact that it hadn't been recognized became justification for more slaughter. So this whole event needs to be brought out into the open. It needs to have the light of discussion put onto it, and it needs to have a sense of reconciliation. And the more you keep denying that, the deeper into the hole of not getting to that position. So that's the overall task for us. Let's bring the discussion out into the open here and have it.